a place called Brooklyn, New York. Now, this is the first time that this group has sung in almost 2 years. So when they hit the stage tonight, it's gonna be magic. And if you know Bishop's testimony, as soon as he starts singing, I'm going to just fall out. I'm just going to let him just lay at his feet. I just know this presence of the Lord is going to be right here. I just know the presence of the Lord is going to be right here. All right. Be ready. Have you heard of a city? I'm on my journey now. Lonely as I got Jesus. Shackles. Can y'all do me a favor, Augusta? Get on.
But I can't hear
pity party show. But I'm simply up here to give God all of the glory. How many of you can feel like me and realize one day, if it had not been for God holding your hand, you would be in the situation that you're in right now? I want to let you know about me. I'm going to do a little rehearsal with my son. Let me tell you something. The enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy, especially when you're focusing on God's glory. Look at somebody sitting next to you and say, neighbor, whatever you do, focus on God's glory. And whenever you focus on God's glory, let me tell you, the enemy is going to try to attack you. Let me tell you this. Praise him. And you know the enemy don't want you. He don't want you to say that. I'm saying praise him. And exactly when I saw him saying praise him, my son walked up to me. He looked at my face because I couldn't get the words out. Couldn't get the words out. Then my son, he said, Daddy, why are you talking like that? Then my other son said, no, get mommy out here because daddy's whole face is twisted.
Jesus.
Well, I ain't saying this to make you proud. I'm saying this to tell you who God is. Yes, he said, here. And I thank God. My wife came. Said, get him to the hospital. I thank God for my wife. And I'm going to say this as quick as I can. A little bit of time I was in the hospital, I got a whole nother respect for my wife. Because anytime you can wipe a man booty.
Come on now.
My God, I wish I had a church.
Come on now.
That's right.
I got my wife right here now. Most of y'all don't know that. You want to stand right there for the rest of us. They rushed us to the hospital. Mind you, I didn't even know where I was. They rushed us quickly to ICU. Right then I blacked out. Before I even opened my eyes, I was in the room already. And when I opened up my eyes, and she started praying and praying to God. She said, Lord, if you got to take some of my meat, spare my husband's life. Didn't even know where I was. But to make a long story short, the head physician had to come in the room and bring in a whole other support groups of doctors. And I'm wondering, what in the world they gathered out of my bed for? And you know what he said? I just want y'all to see this patient right here because those of you that don't believe in God, I'm going to let y'all know that this is a miracle in this bed.
Yeah!
But he was trying to figure out a way to tell Antoine the rest of them that he'll never be the same again. But I had to tell Spanky, you right about that. I'll never be the same again. I want y'all to get out that pity party, y'all. I want y'all to help me turn some chairs around.
Come on now.
They didn't only say that I wouldn't be able to talk anymore. But they said I wouldn't be able to walk no more.
Can God help me? I said, God can deliver.